first side, this walking and bicycle trail that continues on this side of the road may seem like any other such trail, but if you look a little closer, you see a border stone. On this side, where the normal road is Germany, and on the other side, where the trail is Belgium. If you walk across the trail, you can see the next border stone. It is here. On this side, outside the trail, is Germany, and on the inside, where the trail is, there it is, Belgium again. The reason is that this trail once was a railway line, and when Germany had to cede territory to neighboring Belgium after World War I, this whole train line became Belgian territory and remains so until today. So now I'm walking on Belgian territory, and a signpost, if you look a little closer, it has a telephone number, a Belgian telephone number besides the normal emergency number, and Point de Sauvetage is French. It's an official language in Belgium, so this is a Belgian sign. These are some remains of the history as a railway line. This is a sign and a warning light for crossing railways. So this was where the trains were essentially running. And this is an old signal that is Belgian style. And this formerly was a station. It has the German name of the town of Lammersdorf on it, but it is the Belgian style of station signs. A small camp has been set up by some radio amateurs for this weekend. Some antennas. And of course, these are operating out of Belgian territory, so the Belgian regulations apply, and you have to use Belgian call sign prefix. Now still in Belgian territory. This is still Belgium. All of this is Belgium. This little hut is Belgium as well. This barbecue is in Belgium as well. And this is the border stone. Germany, Belgium. So this little corner here is Germany, and the rest is Belgium, and the border goes goes along this hedge. And the fact that these antennas are actually in Belgium has the implication that, for example, Novice amateurs have higher operating privileges because the Belgian regulations apply, which are less strict than the German regulations. For example, Novice amateurs are allowed to use all shortwave bands in Belgium, while they are not allowed to use, for example, the 40 meter band and the 20 meter band in Germany. And according to our foreign ministry, this situation where the hedge forms the border and the farming equipment is in Belgium will remain so forever. So essentially, this trail is a hose-like stretch of Belgium that runs across Germany. Essentially, this stretch of Belgium cuts a piece of Germany off from its mainland so that it can only be reached from Germany by crossing this stretch. There are, of course, some legal catch-22s. For example, if an accident happens on this trail, if I'm run over by a bike from behind now, then the Belgian authorities are competent
because the trail is in Belgium. And if you drive from this road
to this road, which runs across this trail and crosses a few meters of Belgium, then if your license does not allow you to drive in Belgium, then you're driving without a license. For example, if you have a German special license that allows you to drive at the age of 17, if you have your parents with you.